Wir bekommen Besuch aus Belgien. Es wartet die Nummer 2 der Belgier, der ältere Bruder von Kim R.Huybrechts. Vor ein paar Jahren bei den European Darts Championship in Mülheim an der Ruhr zog er schon mal in das Halbfinale ein und schlug unter anderem auch den großen Phil Taylor. Aktuell steht er auf Weltranglistenplatz Nummer 46 aus Antwerpen, the Rebel, Ronny R.Huybrechts. Ladies and Gentlemen, ein toller Moment hier in der Saarlandhalle. Es wartet die aktuelle Nummer 1 der Welt. 25 Turniere hat er alleine in 2016 gewonnen. Er ist der zweimalige Weltmeister. Schön, dass er hier in Saarbrücken mit dabei ist. Herzlich willkommen, MVG, Mighty Mike, Michael van Gerwen!
So far this evening at the Happy Bet German Darts Open, we've seen a Spaniard, an Englishman and a Dutchman through to the final day of action, the last 16, which will take place tomorrow afternoon. Can a Belgian join them? Well, if he is to do that, Ronny R.Huybrechts, the Rebel, is going to have to overcome the world number one, a man who was so dominant last weekend in Jena that his tournament average of around about the 107-108 mark was fully 10 points clear of anybody else. Michael van Gerwen was in one of those moods last weekend. If that continues this weekend, he will be very, very difficult to stop. Dan Dawson in the commentary box for this one. Chris Murphy sat alongside him.
Yeah, well, Ronny R.Huybrechts is a man that has beaten Michael van Gerwen before. Okay, Michael van Gerwen's beaten him 5 times. And none of those went as close as the 2 occasions when Ronny beat Michael, because they both went 6-5, but he had beaten him twice over this format, Dan.
He has, although in both instances he needed a deciding leg to do so. And it has been some time since it happened.
First. Yeah, 2013 and 2014, those two wins for Ronny R.Huybrechts, who last week had a 6-5 against Johnny Clayton that he really blew
100
first round of the German Darts Masters. Well, no such trouble yesterday. Didn't get involved in any of that. 6-0 against Zoran Lerchbacher. One of 2 Belgians to come through. And if he plays like this all match,
140.
Might have a chance.
Well, look, Ronny R.Huybrechts has come into a bit of form the last 6 months. He'd only made 1 PDC
97.
Final prior to that weekend in Dublin ahead of the Grand Prix. But he made his second one there, was beaten by Simon Whitlock and missed darts to take the title, his first PDC title. And then at the start of this year, he's followed up with a third PDC final, where unfortunately for Ronny, he ran into Simon Whitlock again. But just the fact that he's put 2 big runs like that together in a relatively short space of time
100
suggests that Ronny R.Huybrechts is playing as well as he has done as a PDC pro. And he's one of those guys who's just very, very solid. And he's kicked off 2 140s here. He's put 2 in the treble bed now. That's a 180. He's left 41 after 9. And the world number one has not really got an answer for him in a minute.
Well, this is for an immediate break
Ronny
of growth.
41.
Against the man in world darts right now. Is Ronny up to it? Certainly up for it.
Game short in the first leg, Ronny R.Huybrechts.
Well, how about an 11 darter to break the throw in the very first leg of this one?
Ronny first. Game on.
The Rebel, Ronny R.Huybrechts, cares not for your multiple major titles and your world number one ranking. Because he's smashing in the 60s like it is nothing. Oh, that's deflected out, unfortunately.
70.
Well, we do look at the form of all the players coming into these tournaments, but generally Michael van Gerwen has the best form
93.
Of all of them.
93.
The man who broke the record, a 44-match unbeaten run, was ended by Raymond van Barneveld the night that he set it in the Premier League, because he played twice. He's already on a 15-match unbeaten run now.
Yeah, pretty special. But this is pretty special from Ronnie R.Huybrechts. My word, Ronnie.
Michael's going to have to start matching him at least. Does that with that visit. Ronnie R.Huybrechts. Well, I know we're only a leg and a half in, but...
No, tell us the numbers.
132 average.
Oh! The world record! That's 47.
Michael van Gerwen almost set a world record average of 132.
Yeah. Missed a dart for it, didn't he? Over seven legs as well. None of this first to six nonsense.
Yeah. Had to settle for rubbish 1-2-3-4 against Michael Smith in Aberdeen in the Premier League last year. But he's left 170. Ronnie R.Huybrechts is going to be on a rather smaller finish than that. Michael van Gerwen does enjoy
95. Michael Gerwen, 170
checkout.
He leaves it all the time. Not going to take it out on this occasion.
90. Ronnie require 109.
Well, these are the sorts of things that you have to take out if you're going to beat the world number one. Double 19. Gets it. Double 16. Oh, Ronnie!
The second leg,
Ronnie!
Erling Michael to throw first.
Well, we've seen three seeded players make it through so far in this evening session, but we did see that in the
60.
Afternoon session as well. And the next three fell, but the next four fell by the wayside.
And Simon Whitlock was 3-0 down to Darren Webster as well. It looked like it was going to be an afternoon for the unseeded players to dominate. Unseeded player is dominating here,
91.
Isn't he? Ronnie R.Huybrechts with 113 average. I know, it's two and a bit legs. Just enjoy
100.
It.
Well, Dimitri Vandenberg, the other Belgian player who enjoyed a 6-0 win on day one, he came through 6-2 against the number 7 seed Alan Norris. I think it was Alan Norris up there. He looked like him, but he certainly didn't play like him.
No, certainly didn't. Didn't look like the 100. German Darts Championship winner of 2016, did it?
So far, Michael van Gerwen and Ronnie R.Huybrechts seem to have swapped arms or something in this contest.
Well, you know what? I showed a stat the other day about Michael van Gerwen. He has averaged over 110 more often than he's averaged below 100 in the last few months. A quite astonishing
80.
Indication of the level that Michael van Gerwen plays at now.
That's amazing.
93.
He's averaging in the 90s now. Ronnie R.Huybrechts here. One treble, give him a reasonable outshot. Well, he's not going to bother with just one treble, is he?
One out of all three, that'd be better, wouldn't it? That'd be much better! Ronnie R.Huybrechts has hit a maximum in every single leg. Michael van Gerwen was attempting to leave himself double four.
Ronnie required 50.
But Ronnie has had two darts at double 16. He has hit them both. Oh, he's looking at tens now. A curious decision after being 2-for-2 on double 16.
He steps back, takes aim. Will he live to regret that decision? Because that was for a double break and a 3-0 lead against the world number one and the world champion. I promise you he is.
43.
Well. Michael van Gerwen's first darter to double. He's had to wait three legs for it. And he misses it. And Ronnie R.Huybrechts, having missed a couple at tops, now looks at tens. Double five for a double break and a 3-0 lead. Oh my word, Ronnie Huybrechts. Five darts 20. Missed, and all of a sudden that decision to go for tops and not double 16 looks sure even more leg. Significant. Michael and how often do you see Michael van Gerwen apologise for winning a leg?
Game on.
Never seen the light. Never seen it before. Michael van Gerwen apologising for landing a double. And I tell you
62.
What, it could turn out to be a very, very important one.
Certainly could. Certainly could if it changes the game and we're sat here talking about Michael van Gerwen winning a second consecutive European Tour title. What would be his 16th European Tour title if he goes on and claims this one this weekend?
I do wonder what was going through Huybrechts' head as he was looking at a double break and a 3-0 lead. I mean, you
99.
Said straight away that he, when he went for the 10 rather than the 18.
I mean, to be fair, he was 2-0 up on the world number one, averaging around about 110 and hitting everything. So maybe he just thought, I'll leave whatever double I fancy. But sometimes, if something's working for you perfectly, if it ain't broke, don't fix it.
100.
Because already Michael van Gerwen is really putting pressure on the Ronnie Huybrechts' throw in this leg, although that doesn't help him.
93.
Triple 18 comes to his rescue once again. Turn 40 for Huybrechts gives him a very good chance of re-establishing a two-leg cushion. Block a dart and a bit of a snarl from Ronnie having to come downstairs and look at the 19s.
58.
Van Gerwen looking to restore order now. Snatched the darts out of the hands of Huybrechts.
93.
And all he can do is try and apply some pressure.
Go on, leave double one, Ronnie. Leave double one. That's what we all want to see. Leave double one, man.
130. Michael require 88.
Okay, Ronnie. Then. Double 14 for 2-2.
Sure
it is 2-2, and Michael van Gerwen, having been on the brink of a 3-0 deficit and nothing was going right for him, has just upped his level a little bit, and it's been enough to put him back as the favourite for this match. I think had it gone 3-0, the bookies may have been toying with the idea of Ronnie Huybrechts becoming the favourite.
Yeah, well, he would certainly have been under some duress, Michael van Gerwen, because Ronnie would have had the throw as well. Now it's all square after four, and Michael van Gerwen is starting to find his range. Comes into it. With a bit of confidence, having effectively booked his place at the Premier League playoffs at the O2 in London.
Formerly the Millennium Dome, right?
Yeah, I think it was when it opened in the year 2000.
Oh, yeah, yeah. 2000. Okay. Yeah. Oh, Michael van Gerwen. Somebody's flicked a switch.
145.
Playing in God mode again. He's left 36 after 9 darts. And a man who was averaging in the low 90s after the first 2.5 legs is on a 10-darter here and done it as if it was absolutely nothing. This could be a fourth 180 for Huybrechts. It's a ton 40, but
36.
I'm not sure he comes back, does he? Does he?
No, he doesn't. And a fifth leg.
12 darts will do, and MVG into the lead for the first time in this match. And how often do we say it?
Game on.
There'll be little times in tournaments, of the many tournaments that Michael van Gerwen has won, 25 last year. In a lot of them, there were little moments. There were little moments where he could have been beaten.
100.
Somebody might have had a dart to beat him, maybe two darts. Maybe they had a big checkout that they never gave himself a dart for a double. Or maybe it was just a point in a game where they were on top and had a chance to really put their boot on Michael van Gerwen's throat. And they did not take that chance. Michael van Gerwen, either with a little bit of luck or his own brilliance, turned that game around, got through it, and then nobody ever gets near him for the rest of the tournament. And this, in the very first few legs of Michael van Gerwen's campaign at the German Darts Open, may have been that moment. 5 missed darts from Ronnie Huybrechts for a double break and a 3-0 lead. And MVG, in the blink of an eye, has upped his average by 10 points.
Well, it was the last 16 match last week, wasn't it, against Christo Reyes, when van Gerwen was under par for the first part of the match. Mm. Reyes took a 3-1 lead, and Michael van Gerwen just went crazy and won the next five legs in not very many darts.
Yeah, I think it was 62 darts, something like that. He was averaging in the high 110s for those legs.
And as you said, Dan, it's not always that you've missed match darts or anything. It's just those chances. You can't take advantage of them. And R.Huybrechts had the chance to lead 3-0 on throw. Now,
58,
MVG pops in, the biggest finish of the lot, he'll be 4-2 ahead. Doesn't really matter.
56.
He's not happy with his performance yet.
Yeah. Green machine. You wouldn't like him when he's angry. That's the problem with Michael van Gerwen. It's a lose-lose situation. You either let him walk all over you and he batters you all over the hockey, or you take the fight to him, you end up annoying him, putting him in danger of losing, and he does stuff like this because he gets angry and somehow finds another gear. What are you supposed to do to beat him?
Game on.
Okay, and you've seen him turn around records, and not terrible records, against some players.
140!
Over the last few years, the likes of Adrian Lewis, who used to be able to do a job on him. Bill Taylor used to play him like a violin at times. Gary Anderson. But you saw, especially in the World Championship, Michael van Gerwen now, Premier League, you see it week in, week out, doesn't care what his opponent's doing, does he?
He doesn't. I think the crowd were under the impression that he was on a nine darter there. They thought he'd fired in a maximum with his first visit.
I think it's been so long on the European Tour that the crowd have just taken to pretending.
Yeah, why not? Why not?
If we just cheer loud enough and pretend it's in.
91.
That's good enough for us on the European Tour. Real nine darters aren't needed in this era of fake news.
145.
It would have been the best nine darter ever.
Big. Well, MVG looking at another sub-12 dart leg here for 5-2. And the parallels with that Christo Reyes game from just the other week, where MVG was 3-1 down and then just turned on the afterburners. Well, it's just the same thing happening here. And if something keeps happening, you can't just say it's luck or one-off or coincidence. This is just what Michael van Gerwen does, and it is what very few players in world darts can do. When their back is against the wall, they can find their best stuff on a consistent basis. We saw Simon Whitlock, for example, today, 3-0 down to Darren Webster, find something to turn it around, rattled off 81. Six legs. We know Whitlock has got that capability, but he doesn't do it as often as Michael van Gerwen, and that is why Simon Whitlock is number 16 in the world, and Michael van Gerwen is number one by an absolute mile.
Yeah, just seems to have the ability to awaken himself when he needs to, Michael van Gerwen. And Ronnie R.Huybrechts is still playing a very, very good game of darts here. And the last five legs, he's been blown away. Well, the last four legs,
81. Yeah,
been blown away.
Well, yeah, he's averaging 100, Ronnie R.Huybrechts. This is a very, very solid performance. But as we always say, if you average 100 and take your chances, 100. You can beat anyone, no matter what they're averaging. Unfortunately for Ronnie R.Huybrechts, he is averaging 100 and is at 28% of his darts at double. And that is not
99.
Taking your chances.
He has a chance here. Six darts from 186. Can he take it this time? That's a good way to go about it.
150!
Fantastic setup shot from Ronnie R.Huybrechts there. 150 to leave the darts at double 18. Michael van Gerwen is going to be right there, ready to pounce. 47 for the match. Will he get a go at it? Pressure on R.Huybrechts here to stay alive, because he knows that Michael van Gerwen in this mood is more than likely to chip out on 47.
He landed double 16 twice, couldn't hit double top, couldn't hit double 18, does hit double 9, and keeps his dwindling hopes alive.
Well, he does stop the rot. It's not going to be six consecutive legs for MVG, but it might be six of the last seven. Ronnie R.Huybrechts has to find a break of throw. He found one in the very first leg with an 11 darter. He may have to do something similar here to break MVG. That's a perfect start. Well, well, well. Ronnie! That's what we're talking about.
Just getting a little interesting. Michael van Gerwen will, of course, follow up with a big score.
100.
Not as big as Ronnie's, though. Michael van Gerwen on 265. 12 darts is the worst that Ronnie Huybrechts can do to win this leg.
140.
Well, he's going to be on the finish here. Oh, well. Ooh,
maybe not.
Well, well, well. MVG. 79. Just straying. He was looking at the 19s because if he'd hit five of them, he would have left the 170. And he loves a 170, particularly to win games.
But can Huybrechts leave himself handy and reel it up the ante on MVG? Oh,
77.
What a time for a bit of bad fortune. Michael van Gerwen's eyes have lit it up. Oh, having a look at Huybrechts' score.
100.
Maybe just knocked his rhythm a bit.
104.
But this may have to go.
Well, does he look at 418s for double 16? Because he's been lethal on double 16. But he's got to hit the treble with this dart. And he doesn't do. An MVG will look at 86. Same target, treble 18 for two at double 16. He may just get a dart at the bullseye. Well, it is two at 16s. Next door for double 8. Wow!
70.
Michael van Gerwen misses two match darts. He just felt that he was in the zone there and was just going to polish it off, and that'd be that. But Ronnie Huybrechts for a break of throw and 5-4.
Four.
Well, Huybrechts was handed a chance.
Michael, you require 16.
You would
16.
Not think that van Gerwen will be dishing out any further gifts. He wants double 8 for his place in the last 16. And he gets his place in the last 16.
And
Michael van Gerwen, well, it started a little shakily for him. Huybrechts led 2-0, had chances to lead 3-0. But MVG hit back. A little hiccup at the end, but Michael van Gerwen is through to take on Adam Hunt tomorrow. Let's hear what he thinks about that. Talking to Elmar Polka.
Mit 6-3 bezwingt Michael van Gerwen Ronnie Huybrechts und steht damit im Achtelfinale hier bei den German Darts Open 2017. Das war ein guter Start von Ronnie Huybrechts. Am Ende hat es dann doch nicht gereicht. Applaus für Ronnie Huybrechts. Congratulations, Michael. Was a he doesn't look that happy. Even though it's an average of 103 or 2. I mean, it's not that bad.
It's not that bad, but Scheiße gespielt.
As long as you win, I think that's okay, huh?
Of course, of course. The most important thing is to win the game, and I won the game. It wasn't easy because he missed a few chances for 3-0, but I took my chances when I had to, and I'm still going, and I'll probably see all of them tomorrow again.
Yeah, hopefully. Er hofft euch morgen alle wiederzusehen hier in der Achtelfinalsession. How was Belfast? How was Premier League last Thursday?
The Premier League last Thursday was really well. I gave Raymond a really good birthday present. So no, I feel good. I'm doing really well, and it's for me the first time in Saarbrücken. And
this is a great crowd. This is a great crowd.
It's a bit more lively than Jena last week. Last week was a bit quiet.
That's right.
And they love it over here.
Michael van Gerwen glaubt, dass ihr ein bisschen leise seid. Michael van Gerwen glaubt, dass ihr ein bisschen leise seid. Ihn sehen wir morgen wieder. MVG, Mighty Mike, Michael van Gerwen. Der sagt, er ist einfach zurzeit in einer sehr, sehr guten Form.